from New York City, NBC TV presents The Match Game. This portion brought to you today by the makers of new decongestant bromoquinine, the medication that gives you fast, effective, big relief for big cold miseries. And now here's your host, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much. We thank you and we welcome you to the Match Game, a game of judgment played by two teams headed by a celebrity guest. Now let's meet the captain of our first team. She's a very quick-witted lady. Her wonderful sense of humor makes her a natural contestant for any game show. Here is Peggy Cass.
Peggy.
How are you today, Peggy?
Fine, how are you?
I'm very well. Peggy, I understand you're going to do a new play this season. Can you tell us anything about it?
No, because I haven't signed the contract, and you know how often they fade away like old soldiers.
Okay, Peggy, we'd like you to meet your teammates, if you'll step over there. On your left, Peggy, will be Mrs. Ronnie Smith.
How do you do?
And on your right there is Arthur Trudeau.
Hi, Peggy.
Arthur, what do you do for a living?
I work for IBM.
I see. Nice to have you with us today. And Mrs. Smith, where is your home?
I live in East Orange, New Jersey. I keep house for a husband and two darling daughters.
And what brings you to New York today?
This show.
Good for you. We're very happy to have you with us. That's the Peggy Cass team. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the celebrity captain of the other team, a man who's a celebrated writer, author, comedian, Peter Lynn Hayes. Peter Lynn Hayes. Yes, sir. I'm fine, Chief. Pete, I understand you used to commute to New York via boat. Is that true up from Westchester County?
That is true. I used to come down by boat.
What was the name of the boat?
The other Queen Mary.
The other Queen Mary.
After my wife.
All right, Pete, we'd like you to meet your team, and on the way over, say hello to Peggy. She's sitting right over there.
But I'm here to challenge you.
Thank you.
All right. Peter, on your left will be Miss Mary Pigeon.
Hello, Mary.
Hi, Peter.
And on your right is Rick Mainzer.
Rick. Peter.
Rick, what do you do for a living?
Well, I'm self-employed and design checkbook covers.
That may be helpful to you today here playing the Match Game. Mary Pigeon, where is your home?
San Francisco, California.
What are you doing in New York?
Just vacationing.
Nice to have you in our city. Good luck to all of you. That's the Peter Lynn Hayes team. All right, we'll start our first game right after this important message for all people who suffer from big colds.
Now, for you who suffer big colds, comes new fast-acting Big Relief. New decongestant bromoquinine, today's advanced cold and sinus tablet. This Big Relief is now yours in an all-new, never-before-available formula, containing one of the most effective decongestants known. When a big cold makes breathing miserable, with swollen nasal passages, stopped-up sinuses, runny nose. When a big cold spreads pain to head and body, with headache, body aches, that feverish feeling, don't settle for timid partway relief. Go to new decongestant bromoquinine's Big Relief, fast relief of cold's distress. Its remarkable decongestant action brings fast, wonderful, breathe-again relief. You get fast, complete, feel-good-all-over relief. For relief that's real, relief you can feel, get the big relief you get with new decongestant bromoquinine.
Limit your life. All right, let's play. The Match Game is a game of judgment. I'm going to read a question to which there are many answers. You must use your judgment to decide on what you think is the most likely answer in an attempt to match your teammates. Now, you score only when you match. And if you're all set, here we go with the first question. Everybody ready to write? We ask you to name an American inventor other than Edison. Name an American inventor other than Edison. Now, you write down what you think is the most likely answer. And remember, you're trying to match your teammates. Hold up your hand when you're ready. Hands are going up. 3, 4, 5. One more to go. And it's 6. We'll begin with the Peggy Cass team and the man on your right, Peggy. Arthur, what man did you name?
Benjamin Franklin.
Benjamin Franklin. All right, Ronnie Smith, may we see your answer? If you match him, it'll be 10 points.
No match, no points. Fulton.
Fulton, the inventor of the steam engine. All right, Peggy Cass, if you match either of your teammates and name Ben Franklin or Mr. Fulton, it'll be 10 points for your team. Do you match?
Well, I'm on it all the time. Alexander Graham Bell.
You use the phone a great deal. Sorry to say there's no match there at all and no points. Now let's turn to the Peter Lynn Hayes team and the man on your right, Peter, Rick.
Well, I've got a fourth, Whitney.
Whitney, who invented the cotton gin. All right, Mary Pigeon, do you match him?
No. Fulton.
Fulton, you match somebody on this team over here. No match there. But, Peter, if you match either of your teammates, your team will score. Do you match?
Fulton.
Fulton, there's a match. Good for you. All right, your team now has 10 points. 10-0 in favor of Peter Lynn Hayes' team. And let me point out to one and all now, the first team to score 50 points wins the game and $100 and gets a chance to earn extra money in our end game. You'll see how that works a little bit later on. Here we go with the next question. Name one of Santa's reindeers. One of Santa's reindeers. Remember, you're looking for the most likely answer, and you're trying to match your teammate's answer.
Ho, ho, ho.
No cheating.
All hands up? Okay, we'll begin with your team, Peggy Cass, because you're behind there. And the man on your right, Arthur, which of Santa's reindeers did you name?
Blitzen.
Blitzen. On Donder Blitzen. He's the second one in the famous poem. Ronnie, which one did you name?
The newcomer, Rudolph.
Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer. Peggy, do you match either of your teammates for 10 points?
No, I go to the races a lot. Prancer.
No match there, we're sorry to say. Let's see what Peter Lynn Hayes' team does. And, Rick, we call on you first. Which reindeer did you name?
Well, my face may be red after this one, but Rudolph.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer. Mary Pigeon, are you the traditional or modernist?
Traditionalist. Dancer.
Dancer, she named. Peter Lynn Hayes, do you match either of your teammates?
This girl and I are going to start going steady. Dancer.
Dancer, there's a match. All right, that brings you up to 20 points. And at the end of the second question, Peter Lynn Hayes' team is ahead 20-10. Here we go with the next question. Write down the name of a big dog. Name a big dog.
Name a big dog.
And let's hear those pencils drop.
Oh,
when you finish writing, raise your hand.
Oh, golly. Big
and
dog.
In a moment, we're going to have to call time and call it no match unless
right.
You write something down.
All right. I'm sorry.
All right. All hands are up. Peggy Cass, we begin with your team. Arthur, which big dog did you name?
Great Dane.
Dane.
Great Dane.
Saint Dane?
No. Saint Bernard crossed out.
And you have Dane. Great Dane.
The bigger dog.
All right. Ronnie Smith, which big dog did you name?
German Shepherd.
German Shepherd. Pretty big dog there. Peggy Cass, are you a dog lover?
I sure am. Lassie.
Peggy, your team isn't scoring any points, but you have the sympathy of all these lovely people in our studio audience there. Let's see what Peter Lynn Hayes' team does. And, Rick, once again, we begin with you. Which big dog did you name?
Great Dane.
You named that breed, Great Dane. Mary Pigeon, do you match your partner there?
Yes, I do.
Great Dane, there's a match. All right, that brings you up to 30 points. Peter Lynn Hayes, you match it all the way across.
I named a boxer, but his trunks kept falling down.
No match there, but you did have one match, and you pick up 10 points. The score now is 30-10 in favor of the Peter Lynn Hayes team. We'll get back to the match game in just a moment, but right now, 30-0, I beg your pardon. Let's watch as Calvin the custodian helps out the new tenant.
Hello.
Morning, I'm Calvin. Remember, custodian here?
Oh, yes.
How's our new tenant?
Well.
Sorry, but chores aren't done. Expecting you tomorrow.
Oh, the apartment's lovely, Calvin.
Kitchen ain't finished. That sink will give you the willies.
Well, that's just impossible. I'm afraid that stain's there for keeps. I found this liquid bleach under the sink, so I tried it. But you see? Oh, that stain just won't budge.
We'll budge it with this.
Ajax? I thought that was just a bleaching cleanser.
Oh, new Ajax don't just bleach. Been all pepped up with built-in scour power. Really works for you.
Gee, I'll say.
Yeah, like they say, Ajax gets out stains even bleach can't reach.
Ajax. That belongs on my shopping list.
Yeah. Housewarming present.
Well, thanks, Calvin.
Gets out stains.
Even bleach can't reach.
Yeah.
All right, let's go on with this game. 30-0 in favor of Peter Lynn Hayes' team. And if they score two matches in the next round, they'll win the game. Remember, 50 points to win the game. Everybody ready? We want you to write down the name of a winter sport. Name a winter sport. And raise your hands when you finish writing. There they go, all except one. Yes, they're all ready now. Peggy Cass, once again, we'll start with your team. And Arthur Trudeau, which winter sport did you name?
Lassie.
Skiing.
Skiing. Popular winter sport. Ronnie Smith, are you a skier?
Well, the winter sport I was thinking of was Santa Claus, but I didn't think you wanted that, so I picked skiing.
Skiing, there's a match. Good, and you finally scored 10 points. Peggy Cass, if you say skiing, it'll be another 10 points, and it'll be 20 altogether. What do you say?
Skiing.
Skiing, and it's a match. Good for you, Peggy. All right, you're up to 20 points now, and you're back in the match game. Let's go to the Peter Lynn Hayes team. Rick, once again, we're going to call on you and find out what winter sport you name.
Also skiing.
Skiing. Are you a skier, incidentally?
Yes, I'm a ski instructor, as a matter of fact.
Well, good for you. Mary Pigeon, are you a skier?
Barely. I hope I spelled it right.
Skiing. All right, there's a match. Your team is up to 40 points. Peter Lynn Hayes, if you match your teammates, you will win the game. Let's see your answer.
You have an eraser. I said skating.
Skating. Saved there by lack of one match. All right, it's 40-20 in favor of Peter Lynn Hayes' team. They're still in a very good position to win this game. Let's see what happens in the next round. We want you to fill in the blank in a phrase here, and this is it. King of blank. King of blank. Hands up when you're finished. All hands are up. Peggy, we begin with your team. Arthur, how did you fill in this blank? King of what?
England.
King of England. That's a familiar phrase. Ronnie Smith, if you match your teammate with the word England, it'll be 10 points.
I'm on a different track. King of hearts.
King of hearts. You must be a card player. Peggy Cass, do you match either of your teammates for 10 points?
King of England.
There's a match. Peggy, that brings your team up to 30 points, and you're creeping up there. One match from the Peter Lynn Hayes team, and they win the game. And once again, Rick, we ask you for your response. King of what?
King of Siam.
King of Siam. All right. That could be a match. Mary Pigeon, let's find out if you match Rick.
King of Kings.
King of Kings. No match there. Peter Lynn Hayes, you have a pretty good choice to match either of them. One match and you win. Do you match?
King of Beasts.
King of Beasts. No match. Once again, the Peggy Cass team is saved there. Score is still 40-30. Either team could win the game as we go to the next question. We ask you to name one of Columbus's ships. Name one of Columbus's ships. Peggy's hand is up. Rick, all but two. One. Mary, we'll have to call time unless we see your hand. All right, your hand is up. Peggy, once again, we begin with your team. Arthur, which of Columbus's ships did you name?
Santa Maria.
The Santa Maria. Ronnie Smith, which one came to your mind?
Santa Maria.
There's a match. All right, that brings you up to 40 points. One more match will bring you up to 50 points. Peggy Cass, which ship?
Forget it, Nina.
Nina. Isn't that the way they always say it, though, when they name them the Nina, the
Pinta,
and the Santa Maria would be the last one.
Nina, the Pinta, the Santa Maria.
Columbus was on this one.
All right. You've got 40 points, Peggy. One match from the Peter Lynn Hayes team, and they win the game. Arthur, once again, we begin with you. Which ship did you name?
The Maria, or Santa Maria, I believe.
Santa Maria.
This man's a misfit.
Mary Pigeon, we ask for your response.
Isabella.
Isabella. I think that's the one that was scuttled in the harbor of Spain.
Never got out of port.
Peter Lynn Hayes, the odds are against it, but try and match one of your teammates.
Nina.
So, at the end of this round, the score is all tied up, and it's been a very exciting game, one of the most exciting. We'll continue with the match game in a moment, but first, here is this message of interest to all.
What's those little green things? Green crystals. Supposed to get clothes whiter. Nothing's the same anymore.
There's something new in whiteness. New Oxidol has green crystals with bleach.
gets clothes bleach white, Oxydol white.
Well, there's some of that new Oxydol.
Oh, come on, honey, let's go.
Good idea putting bleach in it.
There's something new in whiteness. New Oxydol has green crystals with bleach. Gets clothes bleach white, Oxydol white.
Remember that shirt you messed up at the party?
Let me concentrate on this checkbook.
Got it pretty white. Must be that new Oxydol.
There's something new in whiteness because there's something new in Oxydol. Only new Oxydol has green crystals with a special color-safe bleach. But it doesn't have that bleachy smell. Works on your clothes, not on your nose. New Oxydol washes and bleaches clothes whiter than ever. Gets clothes bleach white, Oxydol white. This portion of the match game is brought to you by H.J. Heinz Company, makers of the 57 varieties, including delicious Heinz condensed soups, the hearty soups with the homemade flavor, Heinz. And once again, here's your host, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, John. Well, at this point, the score is all tied up at 40 points each. We'll continue with the match game in just a moment, but first, just for a change, why don't we all relax and see double,
For the look you love, serve 'em Heinz. The hearty soups with that homemade flavor. And what happier choice for lunch or supper than this outstanding favorite, Heinz tomato soup. You enjoy all the wholesome goodness of freshly harvested tomatoes. Heinz's own plump pedigreed tomatoes, seasoned just right, and transformed into full-flavored soup, so thick and rich, it also makes a superb sauce, just as it comes from the can. Keep plenty of your favorite Heinz soups on hand. They cost no more than other kinds. Yes, for the look you love. Serve 'em Heinz soups. Heinz makes everything taste better. Heinz.
Here on the match game, it's all tied up. 40 points for each team. Let's see if we're going to break the tie as I pull out the next question here. We ask you to name a jungle animal. Name a jungle animal. Raise your hands when you finish writing. Remember, you're looking for the most likely answer in an attempt to match your teammates. All hands up except one. Okay, all hands are up now. Peter Lynn Hayes, we begin with your team, and we're going to ask the man on your right. Rick, which jungle animal did you name?
The king of beasts, the lion.
The lion. Mary Pigeon, are you lion-hearted?
I certainly am. Lion.
The lion. There's a match. All right, you now have 50 points. Peter Lynn Hayes, do you make it unanimous?
What's my lion?
He does. All right, that gives you a match, and you're up to 60 points. Now, let me point out to the Peggy Cass team. They have 60 points. In order for you to stay in the running, you must score matches all the way across. Let's see if you do. Arthur, which jungle animal did you name?
Tiger.
The tiger. Ronnie Smith.
That's the way I like my men. Tiger.
Tiger! Oh, they're still in the running. There's a match, and you're up to 50 points. Peggy Cass. He's got a match all the way across. Let's see your answer.
Well, I didn't throw the game, but I said lion.
Lion, I'm sorry to say there is no match there, and Peter Lynn Hayes' team wins the match game. All right, our congratulations to you. You've won the game and $100 and the chance to play the end game. Now, this is a special game for our winning team. This time, we're going to ask you to match not each other, but the reactions of 100 people in the studio audience. Now, you have to see how well you can match the answers they gave us. And here are the answers in this envelope. Each of the questions in this group was asked of 100 people in the studio audience of Play Your Hunch, Thursday, November 29th, 1962. Now, we want you to tell us the answer you think was most frequently given by these 100 people. Here's the way it goes. First, I'll read the question. Then I'll ask each of you in turn for your answer. And you don't have to write the answer down. Just sing it out when I ask for it. Now, you just tell me what it is, and once you've given me an answer, you can't change it. Your team will win $25 each time one of you matches the correct answer. Here we go with the first question. We asked our studio audience to name something a bride wears. Something a bride wears. Now remember, we're looking for the answer that was given most frequently by the group we tested. Rick, we'll begin with you. What do you think the answer was given most frequently?
I would guess a gown.
A gown. You say a gown. Peter, what do you say?
I have to say veil.
Veil. So we have a vote for gown, one for veil, and Mary Pigeon?
I agree with Peter. Veil.
Gown, veil, veil. The response most frequently given by the studio audience was veil. And there are two matches there for a total of $50.
Gene.
Yes.
This man is a bachelor. I think that should be explained.
Okay. And that's why he said gown instead of veil. Question number two. You now have $50. Question number two, and you're going to get $75 on each one, potentially. Name a famous Italian. Name a famous Italian. What answer do you think we got most frequently from our studio audience, Rick?
Mussolini.
Mussolini is a famous Italian. Peter?
That's an infamous Italian. I would say Christoforo Columbus.
Christopher Columbus.
Yes.
Mary Pigeon, what answer do you think the studio audience gave most frequently?
Christopher Columbus.
Just say Chris Columbus. All right, we had one vote for Mussolini and two for Christopher Columbus. The studio audience most frequently said Caruso. Enrico Caruso. So there are no matches there at all. However, you still have your $50. Let's go to question number three. We want you to fill in a blank in this phrase. Here it is. Side blank. Side blank. All right. What response do you think we got most frequently from our studio audience, Rick? Begin with you.
Track.
Side track, he says. Peter?
Side car.
Side car. With a little editorial there. Mary?
Sideways.
So we have side
track.
Side track, side car, sideways. The answer most frequently given by the studio audience was side by side. Side by side. No match there either. You still have your $50.
That studio audience was cheating.
Here's your last chance to gain $75. We want you to give us the name of a scientist. We asked the studio audience to give us the name of a scientist. Now, what answer do you think they gave most often? And once again, Rick, we begin with you.
Albert Einstein.
Albert Einstein, Peter?
Agreed. Albert Einstein.
Two votes for him. Mary?
Einstein.
All right. All three of you are unanimous. The answer most frequently given by the studio audience was Albert Einstein. All three of you, Matt. You finished in a blaze of glory with three matches on that last round for a total of $125. $100 in the regular game gives you a grand total of $225. Well, I see that's all the time we have for today. We'll check and see what everybody has won in just a moment, but right now ask yourself this. Do you have all the energy you should have? Well, if not, you watch this.
If you drag through day after weary day, pale and worn, you may have iron deficiency anemia, so you feel weak, nervous, tired. See your doctor regularly. A survey of doctors' prescriptions for iron shows 2 out of 3 are for the same kind contained in ironized yeast. Ironized yeast builds strength fast. In only 7 days, you can start to feel your old self again. Just look at Helen now, finished a day's work with energy to spare. Get ironized yeast, 60 tablets, only 89 cents.
If you're in the dark about laxatives, here's some light on the subject. Haley's M.O. is the triple action laxative with ingredients doctors recommend. Triple action means Haley's M.O. is a laxative, an antacid, and a lubricant all in one. So Haley's M.O. brings more complete relief than ordinary laxatives. Triple action means Haley's M.O. is the laxative for you. Get the triple action laxative with ingredients doctors recommend. Get regular or flavored Haley's M.O.
Now, before we leave you, we want to do the grand summing up. We're sorry that the Peggy Cast team didn't win any money. However, we have a wonderful prize for you, a Polaroid Land camera for you, Arthur, and for you, Ronnie. And I know you'll enjoy that. And we thank you very much, Ronnie. Peggy, for you, you know what we have? An invitation to come back tomorrow with your beautiful smile and quick wit.
Thank you, Lassie.
Now, the Peter Lynn Hayes team has won a total of $225, which will be divided by Rick Mainzer and Mary Pigeon. How about that, Mary?
Wonderful.
What are you going to do with it?
I think it'll take me back to San Francisco.
Okay. Rick, we thank you for being with us. And Peter, we'll see you tomorrow, right?
Three on a match is very lucky to me.
Okay. And we hope you'll join us tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen, for another session of The Match Game. This is Gene Rayburn saying so long.
Audience prizes are the new Polaroid electric eye cameras that give you perfect pictures indoors, outdoors. The revolutionary electric eye automatically adjusts settings. 10 seconds later, you see your perfect picture. The Match Game is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Johnny Olson speaking. It's time to play The Match Game. This portion of The Match Game brought to you today by...